Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjali Ammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you in this video lecture on the topic gas power cycles. And this is lecture number 8 on gas power cycles. So we are going to solve problems in the diesel cycle. The problems are taken from Anna University question paper, so that the students of Anna University will gain the confidence by solving the problem. And the learning outcome for this lecture, at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to solve the problem in diesel cycle. Example number 1 from May 2009 question paper. A diesel engine has a compression ratio of 20 and cutoff takes place at 5% of the stroke. Find the air standard efficiency. You take gamma equal to 1.4. We write down the given data. So compression ratio R equal to 20. Cutoff ratio is 5% of the stroke volume and gamma equal to 1.4. And the diagram shows the PV diagram of the diesel cycle. 1 to 2 isentropic compression process. 2 to 3 constant pressure heat addition process, 3 to 4 isentropic expansion process, and 4 to 1 constant volume heat addition, heat rejection process. And this cutoff ratio, it is 5% of the stroke volume. The stroke volume is V1 minus V2. The cutoff volume is V3 minus V2. So V3 minus V2 equal to 0.05 of V1 minus V2. So in the left hand side, we take V2 outside. That gives V3 by V2 minus 1 equal to 0.05. In the right hand side, similarly, we take V2 outside. So V1 by V2 minus 1. Now V2 is getting cancelled, both left side and right side. Now in the left hand side, we are left with V3 minus V2. So V3 minus V2 is the cutoff ratio RC minus 1. That is equal to 0.05 into V1 minus V2 is the compression ratio minus 1, R minus 1. So RC equal to 1 plus 0.05 into 20 minus 1 equal to 1.95. Now we write the equation for the efficiency of the diesel cycle. Eta D equal to 1 minus 1 by R to the power gamma minus 1 into RC to the power gamma minus 1 divided by gamma into RC minus 1. We substitute the numerical values. 1 minus 1 by 20 to the power 1.4 minus 1 into 1.95 to the power 1.4 minus 1. Divide by 1.4 into 1.95 minus 1. So calculating 0.649. Efficiency of the diesel cycle is 0.649, which is 64.9%. So the answer to the problem, the air standard efficiency of diesel cycle is 64.9%. The next problem is from November 2013 question paper, example number 2. An oil engine operating on constant pressure cycle has a compression ratio of 15:1 and the fuel cutoff takes place 1/7 of the swept volume. Calculate the efficiency of the cycle. You take gamma equal to 1.4. So after reading the problem, we write down the given data. So the given data, R equal to 15, cutoff is 1/7 of the stroke volume and gamma equal to 1.4. And similarly, this is the PV diagram, so the pressure volume diagram of the diesel cycle. And here the cutoff equal to V3 minus V2, it is the cutoff volume, and 1/7 of the stroke, 1/7 into V1 minus V2. In the similar way, we take V2 outside the left hand side, V2 into V3 minus V3 by V2 minus 1 equal to 1/7 into V2 into V1 by V2 minus 1. So left hand side, we have RC minus 1. Right hand side, 1/7 into R minus 1. So substituting numerical values, RC equal to 1 plus 1/7 into 15 minus 1 equal to 3. Now we calculate the diesel cycle efficiency of the diesel cycle. So eta D equal to 1 minus 1 by R to the power gamma minus 1 into RC to the power gamma minus 1 divided by gamma into RC minus 1. So substitute the numerical values, 1 minus 1 by 15 to the power 1.4 minus 1. Into 3 to the power 1.4 minus 1 divided by 1.4 into 3 minus 1 equal to 0.558, which is 55.8%. So the answer to the problem is Astrad efficiency of diesel cycle is 55.8%. Next problem, example 3 from May 2009 question paper. In a engine working on diesel cycle, the ratio of weight of air in the fuel supplied is 50:1. The temperature of air at the beginning of the compression is 333 Kelvin and the compression ratio used is 14:1. What is the ideal efficiency of the engine? If calorific value of the fuel is 42,000 kilojoules per kilogram. Assume Cp equal to 1.004 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin and Cv equal to 0.717 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin for air. Yeah. So, we write down the given data. Mass of air is to mass of fuel is 50:1. T1 equal to 333 Kelvin. R compression ratio equal to 14. Calorific value is 42,000 kilojoules per kilogram. Cp equal to 1.004 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. Cv equal to 0.717 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. And gamma equal to Cp by Cv equal to 1.4. So, this is the PV diagram. In all the problem, you draw the PV diagram. So, that is very important. If any cycle, a problem on any thermodynamic cycle, you draw the PV diagram. If required, TS diagram. At least one diagram you have to draw so that you can easily calculate the parameters. Then for isentropic compression process, so we have T2 equal to T1 into V1 by V2 to the power gamma minus 1. So T1 into V1 by V2 equal to R. So T1 into R to the power gamma minus 1. Substitute numerical value is 333 into 14 to the power 1.4 minus 1 equal to 956.96 Kelvin. Then for constant pressure heat addition process, so the enthalpy rise of the air, the left hand side is enthalpy rise of the air, MACP into T3 minus T2, that is equal to right hand side heat liberated by the fuel, MF into CV. And we have MA, actually from this equation we can write T3 equal to T2 plus MF CV divided by MA into CP. So, MF is the, so T2 is 956.96, MF equal to mass of the fuel, MA equal to mass of the air. It is given in the problem, MA is to MF, air fuel ratio equal to 50:1. So, 50 kg of air and 1 kg of fuel. So, MF equal to 1 kilogram and MA equal to 50 kilogram. So, MF 1 into 42,000 divided by 50 into 1.004. So, T3, the temperature of the cycle, T3 equal to 1793.6 Kelvin. And we calculate the cutoff ratio, RC equal to V3 by V2, which is T3 by T2, equal to 1793.6 divided by 956.96 equal to 1.87. And we calculate the efficiency of the diesel cycle, the same expression, we rewrite, eta D equal to 1 minus 1 by R to the power gamma minus 1. Into RC to the power gamma minus 1 divided by gamma into RC minus 1. So, substitute the numerical values 1 minus 1 by 14 to the power 1.4 minus 1 into 1.87 to the power 1.4 minus 1 divided by 1.4 into 1.87 minus 1. And the calculating using the calculator, this is 0.599 and the efficiency equal to 59.9%. And the answer to the problem, the Astrad efficiency of diesel cycle is 59.9%. And the example number 4 from November 2010 question paper, an engine with a 200 mm cylinder diameter and 300 mm stroke works on theoretical diesel cycle. The initial pressure and temperature of the air used are 1 bar and 27 degrees Celsius. The cutoff is 8% of this stroke. Determine pressure and temperature at all salient points, theoretical air standard efficiency, mean effective pressure, power of the engine if the working cycle per minute are 380. Assume that compression ratio is 15 and the working fluid is air. Consider all the conditions to be ideal. So, we write down the given data, diameter D equal to 0.2 meter, stroke length L equal to 0.3 meter, pressure P1 equal to 1 bar, temperature T1 equal to 27 degrees Celsius, which is 300 Kelvin. R compression ratio is 15 and it is 300 cycles per minute and the cutoff ratio is 8% of the stroke. We calculate the subvolume. Vs equal to pi by 4 into D square into L, which is pi by 4 into 0.2 square into 0.3 equal to 9.42 × 10⁻³ meter cube. Now here the compression ratio is not given. Compression ratio is given. We have to calculate. And the isentropic compression process. So we take the PV diagram. We calculate the pressure and temperature at the end of the isentropic compression process. T2 equal to T1 into V1 by V2 to the power gamma minus 1, which is equal to T1 into R to the power gamma minus 1, which is 300 into 15 to the power 1.4 minus 1 equal to 886.25 Kelvin. And the pressure P2 equal to P1 into V1 by V2 to the power gamma, which is P1 into V1 by V2 equal to R. So R to the power gamma equal to 1 into 10, 15 to the power 1.4 equal to 44.31 bar. Now for the constant pressure heat addition process, we have the cutoff ratio calculation. So V3 minus V2 equal to 0.08, 1 by 8 of the 8% of the stroke volume. So it is given as 8% of the stroke volume. So we calculate V3 minus V2 equal to 0.08 into V1 minus V2. So V2 into V3 by V2 minus 1 equal to 0.08 into V2 into V1 by V2 minus 1. So V2 is getting cancelled. So V3 by V2 equal to RC minus 1 equal to 0.08 into R minus 1. So calculating the cutoff ratio, RC equal to 1 plus 0.08 into 15 minus 1 equal to 2.12. Now P3 equal to P2 equal to 44.31 bar. So pressure is constant during the heat addition process. Now we calculate T3. T3 equal to T2 into V3 by V2. So V3 by V2 equal to RC. So T2 into RC. So 886.25 into 2.12 equal to 1878.85 Kelvin. So the temperature T3 equal to 1878.85 Kelvin. And for the isentropic expansion process, we calculate the pressure and temperature. Temperature T4 equal to T3 into V3 by V4 to the power gamma minus 1, which is T3 into RC by R to the power gamma minus 1, which is 1878.85 into 2.12 divided by 15 to the power 1.4 minus 1 equal to 856 Kelvin. And P4 pressure after the expansion, isentropic expansion, P4 equal to P3 into V3 by V4 to the power gamma, and this equal to P3 into RC by R to the power gamma, which is 44.31 into 2.12 divided by 15 to the power 1.4, which is 2.86 bar. And the efficiency of the diesel cycle, so 1 minus 1 by R to the power gamma minus 1 into RC to the power gamma minus 1 divided by gamma into RC minus 1. Substitute the numerical values, 1 minus 1 by 15 to the power 1.4 minus 1 into 2.12 to the power 1.4 minus 1 divided by 1.4 into 2.12 minus 1. So calculating the efficiency equal to 0.598, which is 59.8%. Now we calculate the work done. So work done equal to heat supplied minus heat rejected. So Cp into T3 minus T2 minus Cv into T4 minus T1. So substitute the numerical values, 1.004 into 1878.85 minus 886.25 minus 0.717 into 856 minus 300 equal to 597.92 kilojoules per kilogram. Now we calculate the initial specific volume, small V1 equal to RT1 by P1. So 0.287 into 300 divided by 100 kilopascal, that is equal to 0.861 meter cube per kilogram. And from the sept volume, so V1 minus V2 equal to Vs. So V1 into 1 minus V2 by V1 equal to Vs. So we calculate the V1 equal to the volume equal to mass into specific volume. That is equal to 1 minus V2 by V1 equal to Vs. So M into specific volume we have calculated 0.861 meter cube per kilogram into V2 by V1 equal to 1 by R. So 1 by 15 equal to Vs. Already we calculated 9.42 × 10⁻³. So calculating the mass equal to 0.012 kilogram. Now we calculate the mean effective pressure. So mean effective pressure equal to M into net work done divided by the swept volume. So 0.012 into 597.92 divided by 9.42 × 10⁻³, that is equal to 761.7 kilopascal. That is the mean effective pressure. Now the power of the engine, power equal to M into work net
into 380 divided by 60. There are 380 cycles per minute. So we have to convert it to second. 380 divided by 60, that is 380 by 60, number of cycles per second. So 0.012 into 597.92 into 380 by 60 equal to 45.4 kilowatt. That is the power of the engine. So we write down the answers of the problem. So pressure and temperature at all salient points. We write the pressure and temperature in bar. So pressure in bar, temperature in Kelvin. So P1 1 bar, P2 equal to P3 equal to 44.31 bar, P4 equal to 2.86 bar, temperature T1 equal to 300 Kelvin, T2 equal to 886.25 Kelvin, T3 equal to 1878.85 Kelvin, and T4 equal to 856 Kelvin. The theoretical air standard efficiency is 59.8%, mean effective pressure is 761.7 kilopascal, and the power of the engine is 45.4 kilowatts. We take the next problem, example number 5. This is from two question paper, November 2013 and November 2019. An air standard diesel cycle has a compression ratio of 18. The pressure at the beginning of compression stroke is 1 bar and the temperature is 30 degrees Celsius. The heat supplied is 1800 kilojoules per kilogram. Determine the efficiency, pressure and temperature at all salient points, heat rejected, mean effective pressure. Assume Cp, Cv and the R values suitably. And we are given R equal to 18, compression ratio equal to 18, pressure P1 equal to 1 bar, temperature T1 equal to 300 degrees Celsius, which is 303 Kelvin, the heat supplied QS equal to 1800 kilojoules per kilogram. The specific volume V1 equal to RT1 by P1, so 0.287 into 303 divided by 100, which is 0.8696 meter cube per kilogram. V2 specific volume V2 equal to V1 by R. So 0.8696 divided by 18 equal to 0.0483 metric cube per kilogram. And we take the PV diagram, we draw the PV diagram of the diesel cycle and we take the properties for isentropic compression process. T2 equal to T1 into V1 by V2 to the power gamma minus 1, which is T1 into V1 by V2 equal to R to the power gamma minus 1. So 303 into 18 to the power 1.4 minus 1 equal to 962.83 Kelvin. And P2 equal to P1 into V1 by V2 to the power gamma, so which is P1 into R to the power gamma, which is 1 into 18 to the power 1.4 equal to 57.2 bar. So for constant volume, constant pressure heat addition process, so we have P2 equal to 57.2 bar, and amount of heat supplied QS equal to Cp into T3 minus T2. So from here we calculate T3, rearrange and we calculate T3 equal to T2 plus QS divided by Cp. So substituting numerical values, 962.83 plus 1800 divided by 1.004 equal to 2755.66 Kelvin. Now we calculate the cutoff ratio, RC equal to V3 by V2, that is equal to T3 by T2. So 2755.66 divided by 962.83 equal to 2.86. Then for isentropic expansion process 4 to 1, we calculate the temperature T4 and P4. So T4 equal to T3 into RC by R to the power gamma minus 1. So 2755.6 into 2.86 divided by 18 to the power 1.4 minus 1 equal to 1320.27 Kelvin. And P4 equal to P3 into RC by R to the power gamma, which is 57.2 into 2.86 divided by 18 to the power 1.4, which is 4.35 bar. Now efficiency of the diesel cycle, eta D equal to 1 minus 1 by R to the power gamma minus 1 into RC to the power gamma minus 1 divided by gamma into RC minus 1. So substitute numerical value is 1 minus 1 by 18 to the power 1.4 minus 1 into 2.86 to the power 1.4 minus 1 divided by 1.4 into 2.86 minus 1. So calculating the value, it is 0.5946 or 59.46%. We calculate the heat rejected, QR equal to CV into T4 minus T1. So 0.717 into 1320.727 minus 300 equal to 731.53 kilojoules per kilogram. And the work done equal to heat supplied minus heat rejected, which is 1800 minus 731.53 equal to 1068.47 kilojoules per kilogram. So the work done is 1068.47 kilojoules per kilogram. And we calculate the mean effective pressure. MEP equal to net to work done divided by the swept to volume V1 minus V2. So this is 1068.47 divided by 0.8696 minus 0.0483 equal to 1300.95 kilopascal. So the answer to the problem. The pressure in bar, pressure and temperature at all salient points, pressure in bar, temperature in Kelvin, pressure P1 equal to 1 bar, P2 equal to, P3 equal to 57.2 bar, and P4 equal to 4.35 bar, temperature T1 equal to 303 Kelvin, and T2 equal to 962.83 Kelvin, T4 equal to 2755.66 Kelvin, and T4 equal to 1320.27 Kelvin. The theoretical air standard efficiency is 59.46%. And the mean effective pressure is 1300.95 kilopascal. So we stop here. So you can refer to the books mentioned here. I have published a book on the thermal engineering. You can read to it. And there are other books, Engineering Thermodynamics by P.K. Nag or Rajput, Thermodynamics by Senjal and Bowles, and Thermal Engineering by Bellani. You can refer to it for additional information. I conclude this lecture with a quote from Dr. Kalam. Dream is not which you see while sleeping, it is something that does not let you sleep. So you work hard, so you will be successful in your life. And I have written the books given here, Design of Transmission System, Turbo Machines, Heat and Mass Transfer, Operations Research, Gas Dynamics and Jet Propulsion, Thermal Engineering, Fluid Mechanics and Machinery. Also I have a YouTube channel where I upload the video lectures on the subject mentioned here. Also, I upload the solution for the gate question paper. So, it is free of cost. You can subscribe the channel, use the video lectures for your better learning and to pass in the gate examination. And thank you for watching. And you can please post your comments on the comments box. You subscribe the channel and you can write to my mail ID or WhatsApp number for any clarification. I will answer to your queries. Thank you. We'll meet again in the next video with additional problems on the diesel side.